So welcome again to the Electra Aspirant, an assistance to electrical students for objective type exam preparation, initiated by the Department of Electrical and Electronics, Christ College of Engineering, Irinyalakuda. Now in this session, we'll see the electromagnetics, certain portions of electromagnetics, namely electrostatic field. Then we'll see what is electric charge. Just explain the Coulomb's law, then few of the objective type questions also we will see in this session. First, let us see what is an electric charge. The smallest unit of charge are negatively charged electrons and positively charged protons. Charge of an electron is minus 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 Coulomb. Now let us see Coulomb's law. We have studied Coulomb's law. Let us see what are the conclusions drawn from Coulomb's law. The first conclusion drawn from Coulomb's law is that like charges will repel and unlike charges will attract each other. Second one, the direction of the force of attraction or repulsion is along the line joining the charges. The magnitude of the force is proportional to the product of their magnitudes. The magnitude of the force is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the charges. The magnitude of force depends on the medium in which the charges are placed. So just showing mathematically, F is equal to, the force is equal to K into Q1 Q2 divided by R square Newton, where Q1, Q2 are charges in Coulomb, R is the distance between charges in meters, K equal to constant of proportionality and is given by 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon 0 epsilon R. And epsilon 0 is equal to permittivity of free space, that is equal to 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 12 farad per meter. And epsilon r is the relative permittivity of the medium. Now let us see few of the objective type questions. Now see, if the field intensity is given by E is equal to x into ux plus y into uy plus z into uz volt per meter, the potential difference between x of 200 and y of 123 is what? Now what we need to understand is here ux, uy and uz are the unit vectors. Now we need to get the potential difference or the voltage. In electromagnetics, voltage is the work done. So work done or the voltage is equal to force into distance. Here the force is electric field, so that we have to get the voltage by integrating E and the distance. Integral E dot dl, E dl will give us the voltage. Now while integrating, what we need to understand is there are two points. Between two points, the voltage is asked between two points. Now, between these two points, these points are placed in x, y, z planes. Now, in the x direction, the change is from 1 to 2, and in the y direction the change is from 2 to 0, and in z direction the change is from 3 to 0. So while calculating the voltage, V is equal to minus integral E dot dl. Now minus sign represents we are moving against the force. Therefore V is equal to minus of integral 1 to 2, x is changing from 1 to 2, therefore integral 1 to 2, x dx ux plus y changes from 2 to 0, so 2 to 0, and z changes from 3 to 0, therefore 3 to 0. The limits of integration are set as the distance between x, y and z, not between x, y and z. X changes from 1 to 2, y changes from 2 to 0, and z changes from 3 to 0. So a simple integration we are conducting it, therefore After integrating, we will apply the upper limit and the lower limit. Finally, we will get as 5 volt. And therefore, our answer is the C, that is 5 volt. Now, we will see another simple problem, simple object type question. In electrostatic field, del cross E equal to 0, whether it is true or false? The solution is, it is true. But how to establish that? Now, in order to establish that, we can use two methods actually. One is, you can directly apply the Stokes theorem. As per Stokes theorem applied to the electric field, surface integral del cross E dot ds is equal to closed contour integral E dot dl, which represents the potential difference across a closed path. We know that if the electric field is integrated over a closed path, it will be, the result will be zero. Because if you start from a single point, if you reach back to that same point, the work done is zero. It is calculated as zero. Hence, del cross E equal to zero. That is, electromagnetic fields are conservative. Electrostatic fields are conservative in nature. Another simple way of understanding this one is, del cross is equal to zero. Taking a cross product is actually considering the curl. Del cross is equivalent to considering curl of E. We know that electric field always diverges and moves outwards. It never curls. It never rotates itself. Therefore, the rotating factor, the curl of electric field is zero. There is no doubt on that. Now let us see another simple question. The laws of electromagnetic induction, Faraday's and Lenz's law, are summarized in the following equation. Which is the equation in which Faraday's law and Lenz's law are summarized? 4 options are given there. Now what we need to understand is, as what is Faraday's law? Faraday says, the induced EMF is proportional to the rate of change of flux linkages. That means, here, according to Faraday's law, E is proportional to d xi by dt, that is the rate of change of flux linkages. Now, by considering Lenz's law, it will oppose the very cause of its production. That means, a minus sign should be given. So, the answer is actually C. Answer is C, that is E is equal to minus d psi by dt. We will see another one. Two parallel wires are separated by a distance d and carrying a current I. In the same direction, the magnetic field along a line running parallel to these wires and midway between them is what? So this is the question. So if you know the theory behind it, it is very easy. Now how to understand this one actually? Now there are two parallel wires separated by a distance d. It carries a current in the same direction. Now we can use the right hand thumb rule, which means each line when you take, the magnetic field will be opposing each other. Taking the right hand thumb rule, we will understand that if the current is in the same direction in both the conductors, the magnetic field will be opposing each other. So midway between the conductors, the magnetic field will be zero. So this is only to understand that whether you know the right hand thumb rule actually. So the answer is B, the midway between the parallel wires, the magnetic field will be zero. So thank you very much for listening. So we will have more of